With the blessings of my gurus, Srimati Padmavir Raghavan and Sri UP Raju, I'd like to initiate you into this culturally rich traditional art form of Carnatic music. This is Mandolin Prakash. Welcome to Carnatic String Conservatory. I'd like to start you with a few tips to help you with the setup of your instrument. When it comes to learning any form of music, the most important thing is the tuning of your instrument. So the tuning system that we follow for Carnatic music has the notes sa, pa, sa, and we are going to tune it to the root of D. So we'll be having D, A, D as the set of notes, right? So we'll see how we name the strings in our instrument. So we always start with the thinnest or the highest string, highest in terms of frequency, lowest in terms of position. So it's always the bottommost string, which is called a string number one, and then 2, 3, 4, and 5 upwards all the way to the thickest string. Now when it comes to the tuning, the odd strings, which is 1, 3, and 5, are tuned to D, and the even strings 2 and 4 are tuned to A. So D corresponds to Sa in the Carnatic system and A corresponds to Pa in the Carnatic system. So that's the way you're going to tune a 5-string electric instrument, the electric mandolin. Now, when you have a 4-string or a 6-string instrument or an instrument with a different number of strings, all you do is we tune the same relative notes, D, A, D, A, D, but we just make the relevant changes according to the string number. So you don't have to worry about which exact string is tuned to which exact note. All you need to worry about is the relative movement of D, A, D, A, D throughout. So when it comes to a 5-string instrument, it's D, A, D, A, D. And when it comes to an instrument which you have, which is with a different number of strings, you just keep the relative difference the same and do the needful. The next important feature is the posture. So when it comes to playing Carnatic music, the most traditional method is to being on the floor with the instrument on your lap. That's a concert format. Now, when you play other genres of music, you do have the option of sitting on a chair or sometimes even standing and playing. Now, standing and playing is a little more challenging when it comes to applying the slides or the gamakas. So we'll discuss how the setup needs to be for chair playing today, and you can apply the same thing when you use the floor for sitting or you also do the standing playing. So the most important thing is to have the base of your instrument where the cutaway is firmly on your lap, and the instrument needs to be slightly at an angle resting on your body. So it doesn't have to be too straight, but it has to be at a slight angle, and an erect back is always better. So no crouching, sitting straight, and that helps you have more control and more solidity on the instrument. When it comes to the playing part of it, the left hand is the hand that is used for fretting the instrument, and the right hand is the one which is used for picking. So the left hand position is very important here because it needs to be right behind the fretboard. So you don't want it to be too high nor too low, just right behind the fretboard, pretty loose. I'm having a bit of control from the thumb right on top, and when the fingers play on the fret, I go at a slight angle, at about a 45 degree angle. I don't go straight like this or too vertical. It's sort of at an angle. That's the most convenient position to have on the fret. And as you move across the fret, it makes it for easy traversal. The last thing is when it comes to the picking hand, you want the palm to be firmly placed on the body of the instrument. So normally when you have rhythm styles of playing, it's normally in the air. But when it comes to lead playing, which is what we're going to do in Carnatic music, you want to have a little bit of a base here, which helps in better picking. So you want the base of your thumb to be resting on the body of the instrument, and as you pick, you want that to just graze through the instrument up and down along an axis. And the picking point can be right at the end of the fingerboard. So there is multiple positions that you can use, but always find your sweet spot. I always like to pick right about the end of the fingerboard. Rhythm is another important aspect of any music form. So in Carnatic music, rhythm is called laya. So we're going to introduce you to the concept of using a metronome. A metronome is a physical device that helps you with a reference rhythm. So all you need to do is download yourself an app, any metronome app, or get yourself a physical device that gives you a cue for a certain number of beats per minute. The relevance of rhythm when it comes to playing the instrument is on the picking. So the picking is striking the strings with your right hand. So we're going to follow a certain method for that. So this is something like a warm-up exercise that I want you to try before you try out the first lesson. So all you need to do is start from your string number 5, the thickest string, and go downstroke first, then upstroke, and then downstroke again, and then upstroke again. So you're going to do 4 strikes on one string, and then you're going to keep going down all the way to string number 1 and coming back all the way. So I'll do a quick demo. And then you come back up, same way. So it's important to note, always the first strike is a downstroke in the downward direction, followed by an upstroke. And it's always alternate. You never have 2 strikes in one direction. All right. And this can be applied with the metronome app, and you can practice this in multiple speeds before you start training with the beginner's lessons.